Junkfood Taster.com here, and we will make some Christmas cookies today. This will become a proper anti-cooking, I think. And I've got this cookie dough here. And yeah, we are in the 21st century, and of course, the dough is already ready. Aha, it's ready. I don't have to mix or whatever, I just have to cut. It says just cutting. But I will make fancy shapes, so also experiment. I'm an experimental anti-cook. And here we go. Okay, let's get all the equipment here. So first of all, the brown rolls are cocoa stuff, and I said chocolate, and this is marzipan and fine butter. Okay, I think I need a scissor. Okay, so here we go. And you store them in the fridge. I already let them a little bit, not defrost, but warming them up. And I make different versions. So I make a cutted version. Here we go. Smells like chocolate ice cream. Or something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I always cut stuff. And here we go. And now the cocoa smells strange. Now I put it on this baking sheet. And I sort of build up a pyramid or something. I have not meant much space, so I need to be a space saving approach here. So I'm making something like this, I think. Here we go. And I have even more ideas. So for the super nice cookie. For the second one, I want to have like a round shape. And yeah, so I think I'm making a circle here. Here we go. And it's a little bit like playing with cookie dough, name with Play-Doh. And I want to have it standing up. At least this is sort of the plan. Yeah, everything is experimental. I don't try this before I do a video. Why should I? So no, I think would result in not being funny. Okay. Okay. So this looks like a nice cookie. Okay, so here we go. And I put this on here as well. It's getting to get frustrating. It's not the consistency I expected it to have. So this is my second cookie. Oh. Okay, and now I do it like a sausage. And oh, this was not, yeah, I do one of the pale ones like you would prepare a sausage. Yeah. So I have little pieces here. Let's put this on as well. There we go. Little pieces. And now like a sausage. And yeah. So I'm from Germany. I know about how to prepare sausage. And you make a structure inside. Oh no, now I cut it. This is not what I wanted to do. Okay. Yeah, I sort of fail in here. It has not the consistency I wanted it to have. It's too loose. So I make little pieces. Here, yeah, little pieces in the shapes of my hand. Just dropping it onto the my ridiculously small baking sheet here. I think I will also have a higher temperature and longer time than usual, so that everything is, what's the opposite of raw? Everything is finished. But now I really try to make the sausage. And the skill is not to cut it. So I don't always cut stuff. This is just a running gag. It's like to, oh no. So in the end, oh no. Okay, so here we go. Now my very last try here. Now I will be careful. Ah, I know, I just perforated like this all around. And then I think something funny will happen in the oven. Yeah, we will visit the oven in a second. I hope all my things I created here is just nice. Let's see whether I put it just on like this. Let's see whether something will happen or not. Okay, so here we go. These are my Christmas cookies. Isn't this lovely? So this should be better here. I have a little bit of ambition. I want to have this nice, it's a nice tower here. All right, and now I put this into the oven and yeah, we will check out what will happen. Okay, so here we are at the oven and let's put it in there. It's sort of preheating. Yeah, I'm sort of excited. Okay, so yeah, my little volcano here is falling apart. This doesn't seem to work. Can you see it? It collapses. This looks funny, by the way. Only on my channel. Collapsing cookie volcanoes. Okay. Okay, so we are close to the finish line. It's getting golden now. But I think it can use some more heat since I've created a sort of thick structure. And yeah, so one or two more minutes and yeah, we will turn the oven off. All right, now I think it's about time to stop this. Yep, so here we go, steamy. And can I put the light back on? Alright. So here we go. Oh, now we have the, it's like the blowing wind from the fan of the oven into the microphone. So here are the remains of the volcano. It's very dark. So I will let it cool and we will check out my cookies. I think in the studio, yeah. Okay, so here we go. Here's my Christmas cookie. Isn't it gorgeous? Here the baking paper burnt a little bit. But anyways, I'm not quite sure whether it's ready or not. It feels a little bit soft. But since I have no baking experience whatsoever. Sorry guys, there are so many channels on YouTube which do it proper. So I think it's good that I'm the only one like doing fun. I hope you appreciate it. And yeah, I will drop it now onto my board here. Okay. Ah, it falls apart. Big moment. Oh. Okay. So this was the look like at the bottom. Okay. It doesn't smell that good, I have to say. I remember cookies smelling better. And somehow here in the middle, it's clear that the door's not finished. Yeah. Okay, so I sort of split it into parts which I think are ready. And parts which have to be redone. And I will drop these into the oven again. Here we go, only on my channel. Two times oven heating. Here this is too, it's still mashy, it's not finished. Yeah, I don't want to eat it mashy. And on the volcano, yeah, I will do just the volcano here on top. Somehow like this here. Okay. So this, I think, was my very best. I did quite some crazy auntie cookies. This is my crazy ones. I think it's my craziest ones. Yeah, so if this video don't get likes or whatever, I never do anti-cooking again. Even if people say I should do it. I'm also tired of anti-cooking. Yeah, so I press everything down and then I put it into the oven again. Okay, so here we go. This is the best Christmas cookie ever cooked. Coconut marzipan. Super cookie. Okay. Only on my channel. Yeah. I put it in the oven the second time. I won't take the camera because I have to sort of change the tripod, move the tripod and stuff. So yeah, we come back here. Okay, so here's the anti-cookie. The anti-cookie after 5 more minutes. And I think maybe the problem is also the filling, the marzipan. And here the coconut, maybe it's not meant to be. It's dry. Yeah, here the at the border, at the coating, it's kind of hard. In the middle, where is the marzipan, it's still soft. So I think it's okay. This is one I didn't cook again, bake again. Okay. It doesn't smell that good, it also doesn't taste that good raw. Now in the end, maybe in the finish. Okay, anyways. So this is my anti-cookie. And I'm just eating this part here. It has this. Oh, it's hot. It's still hot. Okay, coconut tastes good. Yeah. And yeah, it's not getting wasted. I will eat this creature. Sometimes viewers say, how can you do this? Blah, blah, blah. Well, I eat this guy, no problem. Only it looks ugly. Yeah, the bottom is still messy. I don't know. Let's not care. Let's eat the mix between black and white. Where's the mix between black and white? Here. It's still hot. Yeah, I think this is my last anti-cooking episode. I'm fed up with it. Also not, anti-cooking has some fans, but it's not getting that much views. So, and I also don't like to produce such episodes. Yeah. I like episodes like soft drinks and stuff. Yeah. Okay. Okay, okay. So at the end of the video, I'm putting all this onto a plate. And then I say goodbye to you. Yeah. And the last question is of course, oh no, oh no. Would you like to eat this? Here, original anti-cookie by the junk food taster. Okay, now some German. Okay, jetzt hier das Anti-Gucken, das Anti-Kochen und der Anti-Keks kommen hier. Und zwar habe ich solche, ich setze mich natürlich nicht hin hier mit Ei und Mehl und so, never. Das würde ich niemals machen. Sondern ich habe solche Fertigmischungen genommen. Genau, einmal Kokosplätzchen und einmal Marzipanplätzchen. Ja, und dann habe ich versucht, so lustige Strukturen zu machen, wie ein Vulkan oder das so aufzuschneiden wie ein Würstchen. Das klappt alles nicht. Das verflüssigt sich dann alles und fällt in sich zusammen. Genau, dann, weil das so viel Matsch war und zu wenig Fläche halt, ist das dann ein bisschen pumpig geworden. Da habe ich nochmal 5 Minuten extra reingemacht. Aber ich glaube, es liegt auch an den Füllungen. Also das Kokos und das Marzipan, das wären ja nicht richtig hart. Geschmacklich weiß ich nicht. Kokos gefällt mir. Hat komisch gerochen, Kokos, aber schmecken tut's gut. Das sind jetzt nicht die leckersten Kekse, die ich je gegessen habe. Weiß ich nicht, ob so eine Fertigmischung das Richtige dafür ist. Solche tiefgekühlten aus dem Edeka, die haben gut geschmeckt. Okay. Okay, my friends. Ist natürlich noch warm. Ja. Und ja, in den Kommentaren lese ich immer, Leute wollen Anti-Gucken haben. Ich habe keinen Bock mehr drauf, ehrlich gesagt. Es gibt Fans davon, das ist, also es gibt ja auf YouTube bestimmt, keine Ahnung, 500 Kanäle, wo ihr dann sehen könnt, wie man richtig kocht, mindestens 500, wie man richtig backt. Und es gibt 5000, wie man richtig kocht. Und ja, da habe ich mir mal gedacht, da machst du mal ein bisschen Anti, ein bisschen Spaß hier. Aber es macht keinen Spaß, das zu machen. Und die Aufrufzahl, obwohl es hat so Hardcore-Fans, genauso wie die Schmatz-Videos und so. Aber wahrscheinlich habe ich habe in meinem Kanal zu viele Konzepte auf einmal. Ja, das ist vermutlich das Problem. Okay, wie dem auch sei. Ja, würdet ihr hier essen? Vom Keksbuffet, vom Junkfood-Taste? Ja, lasst mich das wissen. Und danke fürs Zusehen. Bis zur nächsten Folge.